Bonjour à tous, hi everyone, and welcome to la leçon du jour. So today we will focus on a tricky thing, but quite a useful one. So les prépositions avec les villes et les pays. So which preposition you should use when you introduce towns or countries. So let's start with a town. If you want to introduce a town pour une ville, then you will have to use the preposition à, okay, and then just put the town, all right? So let's take an example. À Paris, à Helsinki. Okay, so it's actually quite simple. All right, for the countries, it's a bit more difficult because, as in general in French language, we've got the difference between masculine, feminine, and plural. So it does mean, and maybe it sounds a bit strange for some students, but we do have some feminine countries, masculine countries, and plural countries. Okay, so let's try to see how it's possible to see the gender of a country. And so the best way to see that is to spot the final letter. Okay, in this case, France is ending with a E, as you can see, and it's in red. And it does mean that, well, this country is feminine, all right? So the preposition you will have to use with this country will be en. Okay, repeat, en. Okay. After that, let's take an example with Canada. Okay, so what you can see that it's ending with A, but actually the most important thing is that it's not ending with E, as with France. Okay, so it does mean that this country is masculine, and the preposition you will have to use is O. Okay, so you write it A-U, but then you pronounce it O. Repeat. O. Okay, and then last category, like États-Unis, well, this category is plural, and then it does mean that the preposition you will have to use is O. Okay, so even if it's ending with a X, you don't pronounce it, okay, it's O. Alright, so let's see how they work. So, pour un pays féminin, so as we saw, you will have to use la préposition en, okay, and then add the country right after. So let's have some example. En France, repeat. En Finlande, repeat. Okay. Masculine countries, so as we saw previously, preposition O and then the country. Okay, so let's take examples like au Japon, repeat. Au Japon, okay, and then au Luxembourg, repeat, au Luxembourg, okay, all right, and last category, so as we saw, these are plural countries, and so it's au, so A-U-X, but you don't pronounce the X like that, and then the name of the country, okay, so let's have some examples. So, in the first example, as I said, X is not pronounced like that, but then if you've got a country like États-Unis, okay, then it's starting with the sound of a vocal, voyal, sorry, and then it does mean that you will have to put this small link between O and États-Unis, okay, this liaison, so you get aux États-Unis, repeat. Aux États-Unis, okay? And if you listen carefully, you can see that when I pronounce États-Unis, it's the same, okay? There is this liaison between this final S of État and then this U, okay? Aux États-Unis, repeat. Aux États-Unis, okay? And for the second one, it's actually more simple because you get aux Pays-Bas, okay? So no link, no liaison between the words, so it's aux Pays-Bas. Repeat. Aux Pays-Bas. Okay, I hope it's clear. And don't be afraid to watch it again and again. Have a nice day. Okay, bye-bye.